So my name is Natalia Pamies-Ruiz. I come from Barcelona, and I'm going to introduce you Soror, which was my final degree project. The project is a magazine about gender inequality, whose main goal is to raise awareness through graphic design. So I chose this topic because I didn't know much about feminism at that time, but I had the need to learn about it. And since I was also a beginner when I started to learn about it, I wanted to create a feminist magazine that anyone could understand, because in the end, sexism affects everyone. So the main goal was to create as well a genderless feminist magazine, and I wanted to represent women inequality through a visual language that would be as modern and as revolutionary as the content of the publication. Here you have an image of the project. It consists of three magazines, and each one talks about a type of gender inequality. It's made by real interviews, articles, and theses. And for the design, I had the fixed elements that are the ones that never changed through the issues. And these elements are the format, the size, the layout, and the sections, for example. And then we have the variable elements that will be the ones that change depending on the type of inequality that the magazine is talking about. Also, the variable elements will be the ones that get to the heart or to the root of each inequality, since they will be the ones that represent it visually. So now I'm going to show you some pictures of every magazine. The first one is on media objectification, and the concept behind the magazine was to represent the inescapable routine of seeing sexualized images of women every day. So I just decided to include pictures of women in every page of the magazine that I myself would sexualize by marking where the reader has to look at. And these images will always be mixed with the content of the magazine. I also created some abstract and almost ridiculous images of women to represent the unachievable standards that media offers, and included screenshots or headlines that would prove the inequality. All of that with very pop, vivid colors that would represent the variety of media. This page, for example, is the last section, which is about the opinion of experts on the matter. Second is sexism in language. So I think that among all the gender inequalities, this must be the least obvious one, because we use words daily, and any origin or connotation that they have will already be arranged in our brains. So I decided to use a very X-ray black and white report look, because I wanted to analyze language and to try to understand why there are some rules in language, such as making the male gender generalized when making a plural, or why the female gender is always an additive when you make a derivate noun, for example. So the role of women is always in a secondary place, and I wanted to analyze why does that happen. For example, in this page, we can see the visual difference between saying that a man has a client and when a woman says, I have a client. So this is a difference in the connotations, and it shows that language itself is a proof of sexism. And I also wanted to cover some parts of the magazine or of the text to show how the role of women is silenced with all these rules in language. At last, the final issue is about violence. And through a really raw art direction, I wanted to talk about the most drastic consequence in sexism that we can see all over the world. And also the goal was to represent the pain, the fear, and the impact of all the people who has suffered from it. There's also an infographic element present in all the magazine, which are these crosses. They act as a kind of clock. I divided each page in 60 squares. And every 18 squares, I would place a cross, because according to the United Nations, every 18 seconds, a woman in the world is assaulted. So I wanted the reader to be aware of it as they read the magazine. Well, this is a final image of the three magazines. So the executed project was three magazines, but the ideal series would be infinite. and they would end when there will, when there won't be more inequalities to talk about. Thank you.
Perfect. Super. Super. Super.